These are the Einstein equations. They belong to general relativity, our current theory of the behavior of macroscopic objects, as well as gravity. But they didn't always look like this. The Einstein equations were originally going to look like this, but for a very specific reason, this term was added. Spoiler alert, it was the acceleration of the expansion of the universe. Let me explain. While Einstein was developing general relativity, he was asking astronomers at that time many questions. And something all astronomers agreed on was that the universe was static and unchanging. There was no start to the universe and there will be no ending. This is how the universe has always been and how it's always gonna be. There is no global motion. This is where the astronomical objects have always been. There may be local motion, the Earth is going around the Sun, but in the grand scheme of things, the universe is static. But this was bothering Einstein a lot. You see, if there was really no start to the universe, then his theory predicted that gravity would eventually pull all matter into an infinitesimal point. So he thought, but if every astronomer tells me the universe is static, it's more probable that my theory is wrong instead of every astronomer in the world to be wrong. So, in order to fix his theory, he added this term to his equations, lambda times g mu nu. This lambda is called the cosmological constant. Its purpose back then was to counter the gravitational collapse. That way, his theory would be consistent with the astronomical observations. But in 1930, things changed. Edwin Hubble, using the most powerful telescope at the time, made a revolutionary discovery. He found that the universe wasn't static. It was expanding. The further away he pointed his telescope, the faster the galaxies were moving away from us. So Einstein thought lambda wasn't needed anymore, and he removed it from his equations. But now, lambda is back. Why? To explain dark energy. We now know that the universe is not only expanding, but it does so at an ever-increasing rate. And the reason behind the acceleration of the expansion is dark energy. Mathematically, dark energy is expressed using lambda, the cosmological constant. A positive value of lambda suggests an exponential expansion of the universe. The current data that we have supports the idea of a constant positive cosmological constant across the whole universe. Such a thing would counter all the mass and pressure from the matter, which would gravitationally slow down the expansion. According to the second Friedman equation, which is just Einstein's equations solved for the whole universe, because of the cosmological constant, we have a positive acceleration of the scale factor, a double dot, which means that the universe's expansion rate is increasing. Without lambda, the a double dot term would be negative, because the density rho and the pressure P of the universe both slow down the expansion. But overall, lambda wins and we have an accelerated expansion of the universe. It's easy to underestimate the significance of the cosmological constant and hard to overestimate it. Since lambda is dark energy's number, and dark energy is 68.3% of the universe, the reason why the universe is how it is mostly due to the cosmological constant. Lambda is the reason the universe is flat. We derive that from the first Friedman equation. The first Friedman equation is also a byproduct of the Einstein's equations solved for the whole universe. And if you don't take into account lambda, then the first Friedman equation predicts that the universe has a negatively curved hyperbolic spatial curvature. Because there is not enough matter, or I should say density, rho, to stop the current acceleration of the universe that we measure, even without dark energy. If you include dark energy particles, though, you find that there is enough stuff to flatten the universe. By including lambda into Einstein's equations, and as a consequence into the first Friedman equation, you get zero in both sides of the equation. Because cosmological constant exactly cancels the right side from being negative. And that is consistent with what we observe, a flat universe. An omega, the number which describes the spatial shape of the universe, equal to 1. Or more accurately, something between 1.028 and 0.972. So dark energy has two roles that work against each other. First, it introduces an anti-gravity effect which fights and wins gravity from all the matter and results in an accelerated expansion. But second, it increases the density of the universe, which helps matter pull gravitationally the universe together by adding more stuff to the universe. The former role is the reason the expansion accelerates, because otherwise it would slowly decelerate but never reach zero, and the latter role is the reason the density of the universe is high enough to reach the critical density and result in a flat geometry. So what is the value of the cosmological constant? Haha, good question. Experimentally, by measuring the expansion rate of the universe and by analyzing the CMB, we have found that in SI units, lambda is 1.5 times 10 to the minus 9 joules of energy per cubic meter. The average of 1.52 times 10 to the minus 9 and 1.48 times 10 to the minus 9. This is the amount of dark energy a cubic meter of vacuum has. So, we know what lambda does, we know what's the value of lambda, but what is lambda? What is vacuum energy? Well, the leading interpretation of dark energy suggests that this energy comes from quantum fluctuations described by quantum field theory. But if you apply the quantum field theory prediction of how much energy a cubic meter of vacuum contains just from quantum fluctuations, you conclude that lambda is 10 to the power of 113 joules per cubic meter. See the problem? Experimentally, we know that lambda is 1.5 times 10 to the minus 9, but QFT predicts a vacuum energy of 10 to the power of 113. This is one of the biggest mysteries of physics. It is called the cosmological constant problem. When we say that we don't fully understand dark energy, that's what we mean. And the worst part is, we have no explanation. But it may lead us the way to another revolution in physics.